Hello students, and welcome back to my online biology classes, that is Biology with sanjayrg. As you all know, we are studying a chapter called as the living world, wherein which today we will be studying a topic called as taxonomy, and in that we will further be studying about one of the very important topic called as binomial nomenclature. As I have explained in my topic called as systematics, that taxonomy is a branch of biology which deals with the three topics. The topic number one as identification of organisms depending upon the different morphological characteristics. Topic number two, that is the nomenclature. Nomenclature is nothing but giving a name or a scientific name or assigning a name to an organism. Topic number three, called as classification, that is nothing but grouping of organisms depending upon their identifiable characteristics and the names. As I mentioned in my previous topic, systematics, is that there is a fine difference between taxonomy and systematics, and that is taxonomy will give us only the understanding or classification of the different organisms. But systematics, on the other hand, gives us the evolutionary relationships of an organism. In case of identification, just simply by seeing the morphological characteristics, such as how many eyes, how many legs, how many hands, how many ears, nose, etc., etc., what is the style, what is the pattern, depending upon these features, we can easily understand that this is that particular organism. If we go further to the topic called as nomenclature, here is a funny fact. Consider I'll make a sound called as meow. Just by listening to this particular sound, we can identify and understand that this is nothing but a cat. But there is a strange fact and unknown fact about cat, is that in each and every place, for every 20 kilometers or 30 kilometers, there is a change of language, and in all those languages we can't say just cat. If I go to China, if I go to Japan, if I go to Russia, if I go to France, I can make the sound called as meow, and depending upon this, people can easily identify that I am talking about the cat here. Like the cat, I can make some more sounds with respect to dog also and with respect to some other organisms also. But it becomes difficult to make the sounds and to make the appearance of a lot of organisms, or you can say that it's highly impossible to make the sounds and gestures with respect to a lot of organisms. So it is a common understanding that we need to give a name which should be internationally accepted, which should be understandable to a lot of biologists and to the common people. Since I mentioned about the cat, let us consider only about India. In Kannada, we call this one as Bekku. If you go to the Hindi talking states, they call this one as Billi. If you go to Maharashtra, they call this one as Manzar. If you go to Telugu or Tamil, different languages and different names. These names are called as local names, stationary names, but this does not make the internationally accepted name. To overcome these particular reasons, there was a scientist called as Carolus Linnaeus. He proposed a theory. According to his theory, he proposed one name to one organism, such that this particular one name should have to contain two words. This particular topic is called as binomial nomenclature, which clearly indicates that all the organisms should have to have one name with two words in them. So let us get started and let's understand what is binomial nomenclature and what are the different rules of it. So about binomial nomenclature, as I mentioned, that this process or the phenomenon of assigning a name to an organism which should consist two words was given by or was proposed by a scientist called as Carolus Linnaeus. According to him, each and every organism should have to have one name with two words. The first word should be genus name or general name, wherein which the second name should be species name or specific epithet. Combining these two will get a scientific name which should be authorized by the variety of committees which are internationally accepted. Some of the names I can tell you as ICBN, which stands for International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, and ICZN, which stands for International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. So, some of the rules of binomial nomenclature. Rule number one, biological names should be in Latin and should be written in italics. One can easily ask a question that why only Latin? We can say that Latin is a dead language. Latin is not at all in use right now. If the languages are in use, people might ask a lot of questions with regarding to changes in particular names. There will be a query, there will be a fight, there will be a misunderstanding, and there will be interpretations of different scientists giving names to or from different origins. That's why the biological names should be from Latin language, and if you want to write it, then it should be in italics. They should be derived from Latin language itself, irrespective of the organism of different origin. Right? So, what is the meaning of this? Consider an organism is found in China. It does not mean that the Chinese language should be added while writing the biological names. Right? Consider the organism is found in Russia. It does not mean that organism names should be written in Russian language. Whatever the origin it may be, the organism names should be in Latin language. Rule number two, in a biological name or the scientific name, the first word should be genus name and the second name should be specific epithet. Rule number three, when these biological names including the genus name and the specific epithet are written, then they should be separately underlined. And if you want to print these biological names, then these names should be printed in italics just to indicate their Latin origin. Rule number four, the first word denoting the genus name or the general name should have to start from a capital letter, and the second word denoting the specific epithet should have to start from small letter. Let us take an example of mango as Mangifera indica or Mangifera indica. Understand, try to see this particular biological name. In this particular name, in case of Mangifera or Mangifera, the first letter M is in capitals, which indicates that this is a genus name. And the second one is indica, and it is written in small letters and it indicates as the specific epithet. Rule number five, the name of the author, the name of the scientist, the name of the discoverer should be added at the end of the specific epithet. Let us take an example of the same organism called as mango as Mangifera indica Linn, wherein which the Mangifera or Mangifera denotes or signifies as the genus name, indica signifies as the specific epithet, and LINN Linn indicates the Carolus Linnaeus, who actually proposed it, theorized it, who is the author of it, and who did works related to this. It actually denotes that the species was first described by this particular scientist. Dear students, I hope you understood these are the rules of the binomial nomenclature, which are very easy and important also. I'll once again meet in my next video, that is a promise. Until that time, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Till that time, God bless you all. Thank you.